Hey guys, it's me, 50, and welcome back to Modern Warfare 3's campaign mode. I just want to make sure that I did not mess anything up since I accidentally right-clicked my thing there. Nope, we should be good to go. Let's just jump in to where we left off.
The goalpost mission.
So pretty much, so far, things have exploded in every mission. Every mission has ended in a gunfight. And I think I've killed... maybe 250 people, maybe more. A tidal wave just went through our helicopter. An ugly ACOG site. I always hated ACOG sites. It's just, it's so ugly on top of this gun. And I get it, it's supposed to be, you know, like the normal thing, you know, but it doesn't look right. Oh, so we're running this way? So they took this from their World War II games. I like how my gun still zooms in a bit. Run, 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 run. Shoot! Shoot the bastards. Welcome to a new type of warfare. Or at least it's a wee thing. Please tell me the enemy is going to take down that tank. Alright, looks like it. Wait, how did I climb up on that thing? Weird. Oh, that's great. The ringing sound. That's in pretty much every Call of Duty game. Or any game with an explosion, really. Doesn't just have to be Call of Duty. Where I hear it most, though, is Call of Duty.
Where did they come from? They just kind of ran out of here, and yet there's no open doors or anything. Weird. Excuse me, is there a Russian that, is cheating from somewhere? Oh, yes, you. The Russian that decides to run past cover through all these exploding stuff. Hoping that they could get the jump on me by running in front of me? Okay. We're gonna run over here. I see there's a dead body. Assuming people are gonna run out of there eventually. Maybe. But I guess not. And we're just gonna push up here. No, but tanks and foot soldiers. Yeah, this is war. This is war now. I wasn't really feeling that in Africa. I just felt like we were killing African Americans with no really goal in mind. Besides, up, they're in our way. Let's kill them. Well, there wasn't a dictator. They weren't, they were kind of trying to kill us. I still don't get why we have to go to Africa and kill their militia. Like, did their militia think that Mark? Never mind, I'm not even going to question it. We're just going to kill. I ain't got the body count. As you know, that's what we do, apparently, as soldiers. Kill maybe 1,000 people per game. Whoa. Did they literally just survive that explosion? Hold on. Thank you. You're dead? Good. I guess we're pushing up. Explosions! Oh. Mounted machine gun sequence. This is probably number 3. If you count the drone. Wow, this minigun sucks. It overheats. I'm so used to the other ones where you can just hold down the trigger. Oh, those are coming. You're dead! And now we're gonna roll over your corpses.
Let's move in.
Would tanks actually be able to... that? And why do we have a quote from Martin Luther King Jr.? I mean, that had nothing to really... Okay. He wasn't really a war figure. We're just strolling along, singing our song, while the Russians try to kill us. Rolling along in our tanks, and we're falling through the floor. Who knew that a parking structure was not made to hold up tanks? Whoa, whoa, whoa! There was a car there! How?
You guys okay?
And I had a normal and...
Can you shoot?
Yeah, I can hold my own.
Alright, basics, fellas.
I had a normal M4A1.
Let us know if you need help.
With a noob tube, and now I have the ACOG one again. Okay. I'm gonna pretend like that made sense.
Metal 01, ISR has spotted the convoy half a click from
Is there any dead friendlies around here?
Around that site.
Copy, we're on our way.
Thank you. You have an M16? Okay. Yes, that will do. Go, soldiers. Keep going. Your fight is not over quite yet. are very limited on M16 ammo here. Launching nades.
Targets on the Capitol building.
Targets on the clock! Cover me! Target acquired! Convoy should be at the end of the street!
Damn it. Okay. He had a good gun. Guess it'll do. Using the enemy's weapon. Oh yeah, and this was the game with the really ugly AK. Like, at least in the Modern Warfare 2, it looked nice. You know, it looked kind of militaristic. This one just looks horrible. I do not like it at all. That's why I never really played with the AK in this game. It was because I just hated the look of it. It wasn't an AK. And I think this was the game that kind of killed the AK for everyone. It's like, oh, no one used an AK anymore. You know, Black Ops 2 came along, there was the AN-94, which wasn't an AK. Ghosts, they had the AK-12, which wasn't an AK. Even though the name kind of suggested it, it just didn't feel like an AK anymore. Plus the iron sights were a little weird. Then you had Advanced Warfare, where they had the AK-12 again. And it still didn't feel like an AK. This was like the last version of the AK-47. And I feel like it was the version that kind of made everyone go like, yeah, we don't want AK-47s anymore. We want better looking guns than the one they gave us in Modern Warfare 3. They're like, well, let's try a different AK variant. And then... we're like, oh well.
Overlord, negative precious cargo. I say again, they're not at the convoy.
Copy. Check the area for any sign of the delegates, but be advised, Raptor 4 will be on station for exfil in 10 minutes. Over.
Alright, some more breach. What? I shot one bullet. I shot one bullet and it ended up killing someone. Okay. Let's try that again. Well, that was a better run.
Overlord, PID on the Vice President. We're ready for extraction. Drop bridge, we got our guy. We're on our way to LZ Neptune. Meet us there.
Nice. I guess the first round's on us.
Cool. End of that mission. Now we're moving on. With Yori.
OC, we've got a caller with a lead on the chemical attack. Says he'll only speak to you.
Identify yourself.
Mac, it's John.
We put a lot of names in the clock tower this week, lad.
It was Makarov. The bastard slipped from my fingers in Sierra Leone. What does MI6 know?
You're on everyone's shit list, John. There's no way I could get you clearance.
Don't give me that. You still owe me for Pripyat, and I'm calling it in.
Easy, son. All right. We've traced the delivery freighter to an outfit in Bosaso, Somalia. It's run by a nasty piece of work named Morabi. My hands are full with the bleeding at home, so you're on your own.
Okay, so we're back in Africa.
What's the security look like?
Strictly second division. Local triggermen guard the compound.
We'll stick out like bollocks in a bulldog. Stealth's not an option.
Then we just have to kick in the front door.
Okay, so we're gonna be killing everyone again.
Just move quick and we can snag where I'll be before he bolts. The sandstorm's moving in fast. We only have one shot at this.
Roller team, take point through the gate.
Okay, so we're gonna be kicking and screaming full way there. And I still have no idea why we're killing Africans. I guess we just do that now that we're retired? I get there's like a Makarov thing, but why are these Africans trying to kill us? And why are we trying to kill them? I mean, again, we could've spent less money on bullets and more on cures, and I got shot from somewhere and I'm not sure where. Okay. Well, I'm gonna stay behind this truck with my Deagle. I'm gonna pretend like I know why they're trying to kill us. Also, they messed up the Deagle in this game, which I thought was bad. It's like all the guns that were kind of cool in the previous games, they just made unattractive. Okay, well, I'm gonna run back and use the remote chopper turret. Yeah! This is fun. Again, with the ACOG M4s, I just... I don't get why this game likes those so much. Like, I see why they like the M4, I just don't know why they like the giant sights on it. Let's use it again. Lethal force against the Afghans. The reason why they keep on giving you these M4 with ACOGs is because they think it's really tactical. And, it just, it isn't. Like, you'd be better off with an M4. Or, I'm using an M4, idiot. A red dot sight. You'd
be better off with a red dot sight on the M4 than this giant ACOG sight. Like, it's just... the ACOG sight feels pointless. Can't be the only one to ever think that while playing a Call of Duty game. Where did I get shot from? Okay. Okay, we're gonna sit in this building. Hi, dead African. No, I just killed some. Hi! You didn't hear me shoot your friends? Understandable, I guess. Sir. Thank you. A better thing than the There we go. Let's grab that. Oh, soap, you scared me. Don't do that. Alright. I will do so. Holy shit, look at all those red squares. See, I love getting trophies. It's just with Call of Duty games, they kind of feel a little pointless because there's no way I'm gonna get all of them. Like the LEGO games, yeah, I like the trophies, but you know you're gonna get all of them. All right, because it's a LEGO game, of course you're gonna get all of them, or could get all of them. But like some of the Call of Duty ones are just really challenging. So, like for me, there's not really a point to get excited about them or check them constantly. Like the multiplayer ones, I'll check out and see if like it's like so many kills or multiplayer or do this in multiplayer, because sometimes you can do those easily. But... oh come on! Of course they're watching soccer. Isn't that a little stereotypical?
Bravo 1, get in position. Flanking now. Multiple hostiles entering second floor room.
We're all these offices just ahead.
Am I supposed to be doing something? Something badass-ish? Right here?
We need him alive.
I get the feeling I'm gonna shoot him.
Gas masks on.
Can we kick him harder?
Look familiar.
No, no! Please!
Where's Makarov? Tell me it is yours.
Our contact with a man named Volk. We never met Makarov.
Where's this Volk?
Paris! He oversaw the delivery in Paris!
Right then. This is for the boys at Hereford.
Where?
Price, I wanted to do that.
We have what we need. Ready for exfil.
Almost there. The LZ looks clear, but that sandstorm is moving in fast.
We see it. Meet you in 20 seconds.
Wait, if a sandstorm's coming, shouldn't we keep the mask on?
The last thing we need is to get caught in that. Let's move.
So I think what Harvey was telling the truth about Volk. He was telling the truth. I bet Makarov's life on it.
Whistle.
Of course. Of course. Right when I thought, oh, we're just gonna be walking to a chopper? That's fun. You know, that's something that we haven't done yet. The RPGs and the machine gun fire kick up again, and it's like, okay, well, you know, I wish that we had, you know, maybe a stealth mission, you know, that, you know, didn't end in a huge gunfight. You know, because, wow. Because I think we've been doing this for about like 2 hours now of just non-stop, you know, gunfights. And I get it, you know, it's Call of Duty. You're going to get that from time to time, but I didn't expect it this much within 2 hours. It's been like non-stop, and it's like, you know. At least there was some downtime with like Black Ops 1, with kind of just walking around, you know. I think this is where I could have cared less about Call of Duty campaigns. Like right after this one came out, I was like, yeah, I could care less. You know, this feels like, every mission feels like Commando. That last scene in Commando, and it's like, okay, it's cool for a last scene, but how are we gonna top this, guys, if this is every mission? Let's see if I can hit it. No. Car bomb. Oh my gosh. Ha! Oh god. We're gonna have a lot of takes on this one, boys and girls. Ooh, an intel piece. For the intel! Yay. I think this is the most amount of intel that I've ever found in this game. Oh, yay. We're walking into a building that's falling apart. That seems very smart. How are there still... That guy didn't even deserve an explosion. Whoa, whoa, whoa. This is the landing zone? approved of this as the landing zone. It's literally falling apart. It's like making the rendezvous point the exploding White House in Independence Day. Oh geez, I'm getting a little bit of lag.
Control! We gotta get off this roof!
Didn't I tell you this was gonna happen? Then we'll have you lead.
Hostile dead ahead. Take him out.
We gotta move. Echo team, what's your status?
Talkie did Nikolai Sharper. Good shot of your position.
Get down.
Really must have found Nikolai.
Sorry about that. Someone's playing me in Words with Friends. So, like, I have the Microsoft app, so whenever it, you know, whenever someone goes, it plays that sound. So, if that plays a couple of times, don't mind it. It's nothing big. It's not my reminder to talk or anything, even though that would be funny. No, we could have been really stealthy about this. But then Price is like, kill them all. Also, how come Price hasn't aged a day since World War II? I don't think I've ever understood that. I'm getting down on the ground.
Where's the convoy? We've got two vehicles 50 meters to the northwest.
Whoa. I'm picking him up. This cannot be a good thing.
Echo 2! We're approaching Exfield Point!
Come on, Yuri!
Oh, jeez.
There's Echo Team! Stop! They just passed the ridge! Yuri, this way! They have to keep moving.
Did I just drop him? Sorry, someone played again. All right, well, that's done. And that's a trophy.
Access code Black Viking. Get me a secure line to asset Metal 01.
Price, thanks for the tip on Kingfish. You should know Uncle Sam's got a kill capture order on your head.
Tell him to join the bloody queue. Makarov's bombmaker, Volk, is in Paris. We need to act before he bolts and I can't make the window. You're the only one I trust with this.
I'm on it.
The bastard used Brigada Industries as a front to distribute the WMDs. I'm en route to their European HQ.
French Special Forces have located Volk, GIGN, tracked him deep behind enemy lines, but they're pinned down.
And you want us to unpin them?
Prosecute the target as needed, but Volk comes back alive.
Or so we hope.
Because we all know that's not how it's gonna end. On an SMG?
Roger, I'll meet you at the LZ in 1 hour. Good
luck. Or no, this is a SCAR. Never mind.
Metal 01,
I thought it was a UMP for a moment. I don't know why.
Get there fast or we'll lose the only shot we've got at finding Makarov.
Roger, welcome.
He's dead. Let's move on.
Sounds like they got hit hard. A lot of rooks in that unit. No one's a rook today.
Come on. Oh, we got the Grinch on our team. That's great. We needed a lack of Christmas spirit.
01, be advised, GIGN is taking heavy casualties. They won't last long. You'll need to double time it to make the RV.
Patch me through to them.
Is there intel in the bathtub?
No. 3 minutes out. Just keep your perimeter secure. We're almost there.
Please just hurry up.
Is it around here? No. It's just more well-designed places that you don't really look into. Oh, gunfire. Nothing says World War III like a gunfight. Every other encounter, or every main encounter. I'm just gonna go pistol on this one. I mean, I'm gonna try to change it up a bit, you know, keep it from getting too boring. Oh, I just love watching that. It's funny when, like, they fall off the balcony. I feel like a diehard cop. Instead of a war hero now. This is exactly what you need to do to change up your game. Let's walk around with the pistol some more. If we run out, then we'll go to the big machine gun. Do you find it to be a coincidence that he asked the two people with Christmas-related names to provide cover fire? Is that a coincidence or actually well thought out war tactics? The people with very similar
and tense in their name should always work together. Again, I feel so badass. Come on, guys, why don't you guys just use your pistols too? I mean, it would be more fun for you guys. You know, give you a little bit of a challenge, maybe? No? Okay, I understand, you know, you don't want to use your pistol. You know, that they serviced you, you just want to use those for cool executions.
How many we got?
Looks like Moscow down there. We're gonna need air support.
Warhammer, this is Metal-01. Request fire mission, over.
Roger, Metal-01. Established an orbit at 12,000 feet. Full load. Marine turrets. Fire.
Nice. He twitched.
Sensors back up, standing by.
Let's use another one. Don't make me use it! Yeah, you made me use it.
The entrance, he's abed.
Metal-01, I'm taking a lot of fuel. Give me 10 mics to gas up and rearm. Over.
Copy that. Thanks for the assist, Warhammer.
On the heel. The entrance to the catacombs.
This is the dead end, guys. Ah. We're going, into the sewers. And you have a gold gun, apparently. Okay. Well, we made it through pretty much the whole mission with just our pistol. That's cool.
Checking for toxins. Hold up.
That's fun. That's hip. That's new. That's cool.
Our signature. One light source only.
Understood. Follow me. Stay close.
Do I get ammo?
One, Blue Force tracker dropped the fix on your position.
I'd like ammo for my pistol. Any of you guys can spare a magazine?
After your location. Mark your route with flares so they can locate your position.
Roger your last. 01 out.
Smells like shit down here.
It's a sewer!
Kill you.
I'll kill.
It's a sewer! Why wouldn't it smell like shit?
The rest of the GIGN. The chemical
strike hit our barracks. Did you think that was gonna be like smelling like unicorns and rainbows?
Mine was at Satori.
Easily. This is why folk must pay for what he's done.
If it would only tell me your rank, because that's something a private would say. Sabre. Saber. Whatever your name is.
Stay sharp.
Damn, Maybe some of these guys should learn that. Stay sharp.
This way. Approaching suspected location. 100 meters.
How many bodies do you think are buried down here?
Don't know.
Too many.
Let's make sure we don't join them.
Jesus. Up, oh, dead Russians. We got a tank following us, dude. This can't be good.
Step on it.
Oh, look at all this beautiful scenery being destroyed. Now that's pretty cool. Imagine if I did the last part of that mission with my pistol. That would have been a bad ass.
General, you're online with the President and National Security Council.
Mr. President.
General. Have you found Makarov yet?
No, but
that sounds nothing like Barack Obama.
On his bomb maker. The situation is developing.
Developing? Do you have him or not?
A Delta Sorry, team I just took him down. I'm sending you the footage now.
What's their status?
They have Volk in custody, but their OPSEC's been compromised.
In English, General, please.
They're gonna have to shoot their way to the extraction point.
General, I want this man Volk alive. I don't care what it takes. You bring those men home in one piece.
Oh, like that's very,
Let's go, come on.
It's very, flattering. that we can't be missing an armor or leg once we get back. Oh! The AC-130 mission that I've been wanting. AC-130s. Oh, great. I mean, I really want to stay in this AC-130. I don't want to leave it. It's fun. It's a lot better than just shooting guns. I thought I'd never say that. You know what? Why not? I don't really snipe anyways. Bam. 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 Let's see what exactly they're shooting at. Are you just...
Let's go! Let's go! We're gonna strong point that monument just ahead! Ready for revolt over secure!
Don't mind if I do. Whoa, what happened to all those red squares? They just disappeared. What does it look like I'm doing, buddy? Calm down. Sorry, pistol. Pull out the sniper for a little bit. We'll use up the sniper ammo. Did my sniper just blow up a car? Jesus, my shot's off today. He never delivered my last strike.
Marlo, this is
Jesus, look at that body count on the bridge. Uh-oh. Launch your nades! Oh, and the Eiffel Tower is now falling down. That... Yep. Thanks, Call of Duty, for showing us what a monument would look like if it was destroyed. Let's look at all the dead bodies. Yep. I'd consider that a mission success. I mean, we blew up the Eiffel Tower, we killed a bunch of bad guys, and we got back to our commando status, so that's good. Just for a moment there, I thought, you know, it was gonna be pretty easy.
They always talk. We got names, dates, locations. Volk gave us everything, even Fregata. It seems your hunch was right, Captain.
Nekaros already making friends.
He's meeting with his top advisor 6 hours from now. Location is the Hotel Lustig. It's in the center of the city near the old square. We have tier one groups assigned to handle this, but I don't think they'll make it in time. But you're close.
Very. I'll contact you when it's done. Nekaros council all together in the middle of a war zone. Sounds convenient. Overconfidence makes you careless. We'll infiltrate along two separate routes, so you and Yuri head for the church and provide overwatch.
The city's locked down tight. We'll need a back door.
Leave that to me.
All right. Next mission.
Welcome to Prague, gents.
The resistance is expecting us. Have a click to the north.
And you're smoking down here. Ooh, this seems like it's gonna be a nice stealthy mission.
Hold up. They've already taken prisoners. They're moving fast. We need to be faster. Keep it tight, lad. Use the boats for cover.
I get the feeling those civilians are gonna die. Like, what are we gonna do? Shoot them? We don't have guns. And how does he how does he not see Price there? Dead bodies all over the place. See, compared to the ghosts, ghosts didn't have anything that, like, kind of shocked you. Like Modern Warfare 2 or 3 did.
Enough chit chat. So, Yuri, let's get on your way. We'll meet you at the rally point.
Ooh, cancer dying sight. Too bad they didn't have this for a long time in multiplayer. Three.
I'll land the others if you don't. Good. I'll take the other. The dog and his friend are mine. No time to hide the bodies. Let's go. Hold your fire.
Well, mainly because we don't know how to do that yet with our game mechanics, so we're just gonna leave the bodies there. I've been finding a lot of intel pieces.
Stay low. There's too many of them. Get down.
Hey, it's Nico Bellic. Too bad he's dead. That guy didn't see us? Interesting. Oh yeah, this is the mission I've been waiting for. Sweet dreams. Pistol time?
Scout on the rooftop. Take care of it. Wait. Nice timing, old man. One stand made, but we've got four men and they've got dozens. Don't worry. I've got some friends.
Is it the African militias that we killed? Wow. Okay. How did they get onto us? Okay. You know what? I'll have Soap do this. Go ahead, Soap. You can take it from here. I'm not gonna try to improvise. You know what you're doing. Go ahead. Be my guest. Kill him. Man, I love using a pistol. Why isn't it blowing it up? I'm trying to, but it's not... It's not working! There. That was weird. Damn it! They're like, run in there, and then there's two guys there, and I can't finish them off before they're like... Oh, no. So now we gotta play this game again. Like, why does it take so many RPGs? Stuck on something. I'm stuck. Huh. Come on, blow up. Thank you. Like, Jesus, I got stuck there and I can't move. Use your pistols. Okay, I'm gonna use my sniper to take down the gunners. Because trying to get those guys with pistols would be just ridiculous. Out of ammo? Pick up a 74 here. Oh, come on. They need a better indicator of where the grenades exactly are. Like, are they, like, right next to you, close to you? Or are you in a safe distance? Because they never elaborate. And that's always what pisses me off about Call of Duty games. And they still haven't addressed that. Is where the grenade exactly is. A minimap wouldn't be nice to know, and then it shows you on the minimap as well on your screen of, oh, here's where the grenade has been thrown and where it's gonna go off. Oh. I was shooting from this, huh? You don't happen to have another gun, do you? Because I really don't want to use this crooked iron sight. I wish it wouldn't ask you if you would like to pick up a depleted gun. Like, I never understood that about Infinity Ward. It's Call of Duty either. I feel like Treyarch doesn't have that in theirs, but I could be wrong. It's just, I always found that to be super weird. Where did Price get all these people? In here, I'm assuming? Yep, in here. Oh, hi, Jesus! Hi! You could have prevented all this, you know? Just saying. Alright, well that mission's done.
Which vehicle will he be in?
The consulate rotate for security. We won't know until he steps out.
You seem to know a lot about Makarov.
Alpha 1, radio check, over.
Bravo 1, copy. We'll dug him in line of sight.
Right. Kamarov's our eyes and ears inside the hotel. Once he gives us the nod, we'll kick this off. What do you see?
Bugger all, mate. Looks like Makarov's late for his own funeral.
Sit tight until we get a clean shot. Then you can put as many rounds on him as you like.
It'll only take one.
Blood Brothers.
It's almost time, baby. He'll be on the second floor.
Heads up. Makarov's convoy is arriving now.
I see it. Four armored vehicles. No visual on Makarov yet. They're stopping in front of the hotel.
Do you see him?
Here's a bastard. Third vehicle. Shite. I think he's looking right at us.
Easy. Just sit tight.
I don't see him looking right at us.
Alright, Kamarov. You're up. Kamarov, do you read me?
Probably forgot to switch it on.
Doesn't matter. Makarov's here. We move forward with the plan. I'm in position. Ready.
Yuri, find Price in your scope. He's on the top of the hotel.
That's good.
Gotcha. We got some activity on the balcony. Together, Yuri. On you. What the hell? Price, who is that?
Kamarov.
I'm sorry, Price.
Captain Price. Hot. Ждет тебя.
Price! Get out of there!
Yuri, my friend. You never should have
come. What the hell's he talking about? Get out now!
Oh, that is cool. Ow. 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 So there's a traitor within our midst. Missed. I don't know. I don't know lines. Soap's dead. It's not moving. We thought him getting stabbed in the chest with a knife was bad. Also, when Price launched his nuke tube, didn't it look like it was a tank shell going out of it? See? Doesn't that look like a tank shell? Sorry for barging into your home, we have a... almost dead guy here.
Set it down.
Oh, you mean okay.
Just patch me up. It's not safe here.
So you give me the gun. Jesus! Shit! What the hell was I stuck on? Let's get out of here. He's leaving a blood trail. That's not good. I'm sorry.
On the street.
Of course there's... There's always going to be more. What happened to your army, Price? Through the basketball court. I'm not gonna hold out much longer. You didn't clear the table. Rest in peace.
I'm sorry.
Thanks a lot, Price.
So trusted you. I thought I could too. So why in bloody hell does Makarov know you?
I was young and patriotic when I first met Vladimir Makarov.
Yuri, wake up. Zakaev wouldn't want you to miss this. This deal will generate millions for our cause. Money can buy many things, even power. The road to our future begins here, my friend.
He's missing an arm.
Zakaev never forgot what we did for him that day. Our reward was power. But power corrupts.
Today, we show the world our true strength. Perhaps it will give you some as well. Is everything ready? Do it.
Thousands of souls extinguished by the push of a button.
So this is Modern Warfare 1.
Understand, Yuri. This is only the beginning.
This wasn't war. It was madness.
No Russian? So Modern Warfare 2. Oh, it's hard to believe that this is supposed to take place a year from now. Okay.
There's a clock tower in Hereford where the names of the dead are inscribed. We try to honor their deeds, even as their faces fade from our memory. Those memories are all that's left when the bastards have taken everything else.
What happened?
He killed Soap. He's gone, Mac.
What kind of a name
what do
is
you need
Soap?
From me, son?
A location. Our Russian says Makarov used to cache weapons at an old castle near Prague. He's got nothing more solid than that.
Can you trust him?
What choice do I have? He's got his own reasons for wanting Makarov dead. Place ring any bells?
Aye. We ran drones over a suspect castle back in Zakiev's day, but we never got wind of our targets visiting the area.
What am I up against?
The place is a fortress. Only one way in or out. Unless you've learned to fly. Security office on the far side of the compound, and a command center north of that. Both were heavily guarded. If Makarov's there, he'll be in that control room. What's this you're sending me?
Equipment list.
That's a lot of hardware, John. What you plan on doing?
What you taught me to do. Kill them all.
Stronghold. Oh yeah, night vision goggles.
Keep up or I'll leave you behind.
Get down. Get caught in those lights and we're done before we started.
So we have a James Bond pistol. P99. Good thing I didn't shoot.
When we're down there, you move when I move, do as I do. Understand? Let's go. Hold. Only shoot at what you can kill.
Does that work for you? I shoot what I need to. Damn it. She said, take him out. Guess that meant don't shoot him.
Wait for it. Now. Over here.
Пытаешься выглядеть занятым, Миша. Эй, чё? Делать-то нечего. По крайней мере, некоторым хоть какое-то дело.
Oh, it's lovely stuff. That's... I get the feeling that we're gonna blow shit up.
Clear, go.
got cameras outside the command center, both sides, here and here. Yeah, well, we just have to knock on the door.
Killed too many prisoners. Okay, I won't kill the prisoners. This is where the pistol really becomes nice.
They're using flares!
Take your night vision off, we'll do this the old way.
Which is run in and just kill everyone in sight. Of course they want to ruin the fun of it. See, the reason why I'm doing it in a different key and different tone is because I'm not really James Bond. It's like the American version that no one really cares for. So, I mean, I don't want to say that's Mission Impossible, but I think that's like the only American American spy franchise that's been going on for a long time. Usually we do like just huge bunches of spy movies, but you know, with different casts and you know, never the same franchise. It's always like one-offs. Which can kind of suck. You know, it's kind of sad that we don't have something like James Bond. You know, that's, you know, like an American version of them. Like, I get that the James Bond films are made by Americans, but but it would be nice if we had an American spy that, you know, did really well, too.
We have about 10 minutes until they find their dead.
You sure about 10 minutes? From the sounds of it, it seems like they already know. Ow.
This bridge is the only way in or out of the base. Plant some more C4 on the column.
I don't know why, but it feels like we're like blowing up Castle Wolfenstein or something. I don't know why though.
Hmm.
Change of plan. Control center is just above us.
Oh, what are you doing?
Looks like we won't have to shoot our way in.
Explosive duct tape, okay.
The thunder will hide the sound of the blast. Wait for my signal.
Jesus.
We can climb up here. Come on.
Is it just me, or is Makarov's voice really weird? It's what I never understood about this game is why they got a, like, him as the voice actor.
Alex, has your intel confirmed?
Yes, sir. Our men are on the way to Berlin.
Are you listening?
Our daughter is there. We will have her in a matter of hours.
Keep me updated.
Time to go.
Что здесь происходит? Вы получили ответ от охраны или нет? Опускать людей! Опускать территорию! Граната!
Jesus! Oh, hi! I engulfed the guy in flames. Dead chicken. Even the music right here kind of sounds Mission Impossible-ish. I always hate that flashbang noise. It's just always annoying.
Yuri, don't slow down now! Slow them out!
So if you want to annoy me in a Call of Duty game, you know, use flashbangs over and over and over again. Not because of how it blinds you, it's because of the sounds. Price? Do we have a problem here? I have no ammo whatsoever. So we gotta kill some bastards. Thank you. Oh, ugly ass AK. Well, it says to go here, so... Oh, shit! Oh, shit indeed. Oh, Price, how are we gonna get out of this one? And I have no ammo again. Excuse me. I couldn't hold that one back. Oh shit.
Fly like an eagle.
Well, that was a cool one. Probably should turn on my light. Because it's getting dark.
Nikolov tracked Vorshevsky's daughter to Berlin. If they find the girl, it's only a matter of time till he gives up the nuclear codes.
I always try to like have natural sunlight into the room. So when it gets around like 8 o'clockish, I gotta turn on a light or two.
Alana Vorshevsky? American Special Forces, do you speak English?
Yes, my security's dead. They're coming for me.
Stay calm, we're en route to you now. Where are you exactly?
Closet, fifth floor suite.
Which side?
I don't know. There's a building across the road. A sign on the roof says Riesdorf. Please hurry.
Okay, put the phone down and don't move. We'll come to you. Athena is still with us. Weapons tight and don't throw any shots.
Sorry.
Oh shit. I'm not ready for this.
Okay, ACR would have looked great with normal iron sights. We throw a holographic on. Okay. Yeah, let's throw a nade in there. Did it ever go off? Nope. 1, 2, 3. Toss. There we go. Sorry. I can't keep moving if I'm gonna be killed. I just got myself healed up, and now I'm being... Yeah, this game's AI has not been very cooperative with me. It doesn't like me too much. At least so it seems.
Secure this area fast!
What does it look like I'm doing, man?
Granite 01, overwatch established.
Copy that, we're inbound.
Could you imagine doing this sequence with like an ACR or something?
Take it from here.
Armor's down, Brandon. You're good to go.
Copy.
Launching now.
Granite, have you got eyes on Athena?
Affirmative. Shit, left side. Got two more. Get out, get out.
Oh.
Granite? Granite!
They're gone.
What the hell?
Overlord, Granite team is down. I repeat, Eagle's down. We're going after Athena.
Affirmative, Sandman. Link up with the German tank column south of your position and proceed to the target building. Over.
Solid copy. Sandman out. Look up. We need to hit the street.
Yay, a rappel sequence. We haven't had one of these yet. Well, it didn't let us manually jump down. Just did the pull. What is that?
Got some casualties here.
Grab their patches and tags. And get Starbirds in here and get them out.
Roger. It's Onyx team.
Ooh.
Overlord, this is Metal 02. I need an evac for 3 casualties. That's a... Coordinates
followed. I've been collecting a good amount of intelligence this time around.
American team, we have Russian armor firing on the bridge. We need you to take out their tank.
Oh. Oh, come on.
Follow 7, Romeo 851.
American team, we have Russian armor firing on the bridge. We need you to take out that tank.
T-9 dug in straight ahead.
Frost, take care of it. We'll cover you. Grab an RPG and take out that tank.
So I assume we just keep firing? Did that guy's head literally just explode like a grenade when I shot it? Man, that noise just gets so annoying. Stop it with that stupid... What?! Oh, my foot gets ran over by a tank and then I absolutely die. Okay. It wasn't even my full foot, it was just... Like just muting the sound to my headset during this part. If it's gonna keep doing that high-pitched screech noise. I mean, come on, it gets so... You can only... Really? You can only tolerate so much of it. Come on. Those tanks are not good cover. I swear. The next game that I'm going to be doing after this one is not going to be a first-person shooter. Because I am tired of hearing that flashbang noise. Yes, that one. Can't stand it. It's so annoying. What the hell hit me? Come on. I hate this sequence. I think I even hated it back in the day because the tanks did not give you any sort of cover. Oh, use the tanks for cover. Yeah, they're coming from both sides. That only leaves me with one area of the tank to go to. See? Doesn't matter where you go. These tanks cannot be used as good cover. See, you can't use it for cover. You can't. Shut up with the fucking flashbang noise. Now I know why I never played this game after this, because I knew I'd get to this mission and have to listen to boing in my ear constantly over and over and over again. See, we didn't need it for that explosion. Why did we need it for everything else? Yes! This is!
This thing's gonna come down on us any second. Just keep moving.
This is what I wanted. Something besides shooting. Just a little bit of walking and getting a little back into shooting. Okay. Well, I guess I can't complain. It's not like the first act where it was every mission was a firefight. For the queen!
Let's go!
I'm already here! Jesus! You're the guys that are taking forever. Hurry, she's yelling and screaming.
Frost, hit the door.
With pleasure. Oh, Jesus. I may not have enough bullets. That means the game time has been extended. And it says objective completed. No, objective failed. We didn't get her.
Price, we lost the girl. Looks like the Hilo took her to a diamond mine in Siberia.
We're gonna have one shot to grab the president before he gives up the launch codes and Makarov turns Europe into glass. Once we get boots on the ground, it's gonna get lively down there.
Hopefully you can keep up, old man.
I know you Yanks like to take all the credit, so Yuri and I'll keep the neighbors in check while we roll out to secure the hostages.
Okay, weapons tight, guys. No one likes a dead hostage.
What's the score, boss?
Everyone's hostile.
Ain't that the truth?
Down the rabbit hole.
Ready? Easy, Grinch. Top off your rifles. Get ready.
My magazine was fully loaded, you guys. Now. I am in cover. Shut up, game. Man, we are just killing so many people. I get it, it's World War III. People are going to die a lot, but Jesus! This feels like a James Bond base! It would have been nice if someone had a grenade or noob tube there. Why are they shooting RPGs? I think this is the game where you could tell that Infinity Ward was kind of losing their touch. Because I think Infinity Ward did the campaign while Sledgehammer did the multiplayer. And this campaign is just... it's very repetitive of everything that they've ever done, and... it's just fight scene after fight scene after fight scene. There's not really a talk scene or anything like that. Like that... the like, prologue cutscene is like the only cutscene that you're actually kind of a part of. You know, where all the rest of it is this. And it's just... yeah, I wish that, this campaign was different. I feel like this could have been so much more, and it just became repeat levels of the same thing. You know, it feels like one giant spec op mission after the other. And I get it, it's like World War III, but it just... there's more than just killing huge amounts of people in war. I mean... you know, at least the first one, you know, showed, like, different people's perspective, or I should say the first ever Call of Duty, and the second one, and maybe even the third one. They showed the war from different sides. You just kind of see this war from, you know, the good guy's side, and that's it. I wish that you kind of saw more of, like, the Russians realizing that, oh, you know, they're in this war by mistake or something. I don't know. I wish that there was more that could have been done with this game. It's just... this campaign is... dull. You know, it had, like, maybe one cool mission in it so far, which is that castle mission, but... besides that, I'm not really liking any of these other missions. They really do feel like Spec Ops missions, and heck... they even put them into Spec Ops. Nope. So, I don't know. I just feel like this campaign wasn't as good as some of the other Call of Duty campaigns. You know, and you're probably thinking to yourself, well, if you don't really like the campaign, why are you recording it? You know, sometimes I think the games that... you know, are flawed are sometimes the ones that you should play through and kind of see what they did wrong. You know, just kind of critique the game a little bit. You know, compare it to some of the other games in its series. And I want you guys to kind of see, like, me playing through each Call of Duty and seeing, okay, well, this was a new thing for Call of Duty. This is something that was just more the same. You know, this feels a lot like this. This feels like, you know, this kind of movie or... this previous version of Call of Duty, you know? Or to see, oh, this added stuff to the table, this did not, you know? That kind of thing. You know, it's not that rare that something feels like something else. But the Spec Ops missions were more fun than this. I do have to admit. The DLC ones, I remember, were kind of fun. That's back when Drill let me download them. Because I was not going to pay for DLC for this game. It's just that... I had the same feeling then as I kind of do now, right? It's not a bad game, but it's not good either, you know? You know, it's one of those games where, over time, the multiplayer got better. The Spec Ops missions were fun from the start, and the campaign just felt like all the Spec Ops missions that they really wanted to put into the game just with a tied story to it. It just felt like all the Spec Ops missions combined. You know, and some of Modern Warfare 2 Spec Ops missions were like that, but the story was the big part that really came along quite well, and now it's kind of lacking story-wise. Like, I'm not holding into the story, I'm not really enjoying it too much. Because it does feel a lot like, you know, Modern Warfare 2. Almost like reject pieces from Modern Warfare 2. Like, oh, we didn't have time to put this into the game, but this is what we're going to put in there. You know, whether it was a spec op mission or a normal mission, that's kind of what this felt like. And then Ghosts was, let's just take our best moments from the previous games and, put them together.
Yuri, take care of the door! Wait! It's the door!
Battle 01, what is your status? Have you secured the president?
Negative, Overlord, but we have the girl.
We'll prep a team for extraction. Continue searching for the president.
She's trying to say something. She said they took her father deeper into the mine. Overlord,
that's where we're going. Come on.
7015. I need a medevac for a
The music's always nice in Call of Duty games, but. Like, the music is always good, and sure, I always get copyright claims for it, since, like, you can't turn off the music for some reason. I went into the options, and it wouldn't let me turn off the music. So sure, there's a lot of, like, that kind of thing, but... Were we just in this section? Not too long ago? I feel like we went full circle. Like, even part of this kind of feels like, they took stuff, like, deleted scenes from Black Ops. Just like the kind of, location and things like that. Just, I don't know, it feels like this was a part of a different game and then was put in here. Same with the Africa mission, to be quite honest. It feels like, oh, it was part of a different game, you know, but we're just gonna throw it in here. Or it's a deleted scene from... I did not kill the president. Whatever.
Get charges here, here, and here.
Yeah. Like I said before, this is where I feel like Infinity Ward kind of went downhill. Is this game. Because this, its multiplayer was all sledgehammer. You know, and then when they did their own for Ghosts, it didn't live up, the campaign didn't live up in this one or the other one. So I wish there was just a little something more, a little something different. See, I like to think that each Call of Duty brought something new to it. For each of the different pieces of a Call of Duty game, you know, whether it's the campaign, whether it's the multiplayer, or whether it's bonus content, which would be like zombies or Spec Ops. And I feel like this one was very good when it came to making new multiplayer changes, which was definitely on the Sledgehammer side, and then Spec Ops 2, I think, was Sledgehammer. So I wish that there was,
damn it.
I don't see what's new about this campaign. Black Ops 1, it was more of, kind of a different setting, which was nice. The different settings with the Call of Duty, like the Treyarch Call of Duties, were always nice. It always kept things kind of fresh, and, it was very informational, and I liked that, it being, either in World War II and showing you a little bit of the classic World War II battles, whether it was Black Ops and showing you, like, the Bay of Pigs or, stuff like that. I personally liked that stuff. And the Modern Warfare ones, the first one was, just kind of what set up the course. The second one showed how big and how grand you can go. And this one was just more of the same. So. And then Ghosts was just copy and paste of everything else. And just, like, pretty much all aspects of it. They had their alien mode, which was supposed to be zombies. Their multiplayer was pretty much the Sledgehammer version, or the Black Ops 2 version, but with all these different perks. And then they also took from the Sledgehammer book a bit. And then their story was just so bland, it's not even funny. But it's still a better love story than Twilight, and there wasn't even any love in that story. So. Ghosts, I'm talking about, not Twilight. Apparently there was love in there.
We cross now to the Rose Garden, where the President is holding a press conference with Russian Premier Voroshilov to formally announce an end to the hostilities.
On this historic day, the representatives of two great nations stand before you united.
There's a simplicity to war. Attacking is the only secret. Dare, and the world yields.
A chapter in which we pursue peace.
How quickly they forget that all it takes to change the course of history is the will of a single man.
Who's this?
Prisoner 627. I'm coming for you, Makarov.
Haven't you heard, Price? They say the war is over.
My war ends with you.
Like it ended for Captain McTavish? Tell me, Price, how long did it take him to die? I've destroyed your world piece by piece. It's only a matter of time until I find you.
You won't have to look far.
Oh. Looks like we're gonna kill some bitches!
Protect us.
It'll buy us time. Nikolai, are you patched into their system?
Working on it. My Arabic's a little rusty.
Dust to dust. Oh yeah, juggernaut suits. This is gonna be fun.
Looks like they know we're here.
I've tapped into their security feed. Makarov's in the atrium on the top floor. This is it. Makarov doesn't leave here alive. Get ready.
I am Iron Man.
We've got their attention. Second wave of responders will be coming in any moment. Here they come, right on
schedule. No. Russian.
It won't help him. Take it for the lift. I can't escape.
time to die. Oh, Makarov! I said I'd be back. And I am back. For all that we have lost in Makarov's hand. Time to die.
Makarov's most of the restaurant, same floor. He's got a large security detail with him.
What kind of opposition is waiting for us?
40 plus foot mobiles, SMGs and assault rifles. Enemy chopper closing on your position.
Sounds like a piece of cake.
Probably going to Makarov.
What? Ow. I jumped to it. It said jump, and I jumped. No, no, no. We're using this bad boy.
Oh, come on. Come on! I shot a grenade at him! Grenade launcher, and how did that not kill him?
Restaurant's this way!
He's still there! You've almost got him!
There he
Fury's dead.
Believe me. Don't let him get away.
I did say no Russian. Survived. Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker. I'll see you in hell. Now he is no more. I consider that a job well done. If it looks a little choppy, that's because it does. In game, it looks pretty choppy. Mission accomplished. And so the trilogy ends. So thank you guys for watching. That's another game that I finished in a whole day of recording. So thank you guys so much for watching. I am going to mute my mic. That way you guys can enjoy the credits. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. And I think the next Call of Duty that we'll do is probably Black Ops 1. Yeah, I think we'll do that one next. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time. Stay frosty.